All right, so there's something that I would like to share that's been on my chest. We are living in very, very interesting times. And in these times, there's a lot of energy moving around this planet. And there's a lot of energy that's stressed and a lot of unsettled energy that's happening. Everyone can feel it. There's a strong wave of energy, a very powerful energy that's moving around the planet. So what comes with this energy is high vibrational energy and low vibrational energy. With the low vibrational energy, it seeks to draw energy from the light beings, from the high vibrational energy. And they come in the form of energy vampires. Energy vampires are very real, okay? They show up, they're looking to attach itself. They come in in the most sneakiest, cleverest, and even mysterious ways. They come in disguise. They show up in your life as if they are almost worshiping you, and really as if they're trying to honor you, or they have this over sense of reverence for you, or this excessive amount of love for you. When most of the times they don't even know you, okay? They may come to support your business, or to attempt or to appear to be supporting your business, but what they're looking for is access to your energy. So the message to the light beings is to be mindful, okay? Not all the money that you're receiving or that's coming to you is always in your best benefit. It's not always in the best benefit just because someone wants to pay your price. And sometimes those energies are coming and they seem to want to pay your highest price. They seem to give anything to have access or to be close to your vibration, anything to have a piece of you, anything they can do to get close to you, to get access to you. And you know, this energy doesn't only come from strangers or strange energy or new energy or somebody looking to support. It also will come from sometimes the energies that's close to you. So we have to be very mindful of energy suckers. And if you feel drained after having a conversation, or if there's a business transaction that's happening, and these are for entrepreneurs because you know, they are and influencers, entrepreneurs and influencers and creatives and spiritual beings, and especially those who are working in the field of spirituality at this time, because at this time, you know, there are a lot of people, a lot of spirits disguised as people who are looking to gravitate, to take from, to suck on to high vibrational beings, or to those who seem to have it together, or to seem to be the leaders. Those are the ones that people want any pieces of you, or any part of you, or those energies are looking to suck from you. Why? Because you have something that's very valuable. Your energy, your high vibrational energy, your spirit, your light. You know, that dark energy, because it's dark energy, whether they know that the energy is dark or not, whether it's intentional or not. Okay, because sometimes, you know, the people who's carrying this energy, they don't even know what they're doing. They don't even understand what's happening because it's a whole nother being, a whole nother spirit inside of their body. And that's coming to take from your energy. So what's happening here on this planet right now? We are in a war. We are in a spiritual war. Okay, and in this spiritual war, you better believe that that war, as much as it may be seen, a lot of the enemies that are coming cannot be seen, okay? But you can feel it. It can be felt. The attacks are silent. These are silent attacks. So just as we see the bold attacks with racism these days, and the bold attacks with the epidemic or the pandemic, you know, it's the same way that you're gonna feel the boldness, the audacity of these energies coming to steal from you. So by all means, you protect your energy. You keep your energy clear. You be mindful of strange behavior, Be mindful of strange communications. Be mindful of communications that seem to be a little off. Pay attention to your intuition. If it feels off, it's off. You can second guess. You can always second guess yourself, because second guessing yourself is great, because it gives you an opportunity to prove yourself right. So sometimes you may just want to see. Let me just see what happens next. You know, that's a dangerous game to play. So that means that you're willing to go ahead and jump in the fire, because you're willing to get burned by the fire a little bit just to see what happens next. If you're strong enough, I say go ahead and see. Why? Because sometimes you need to get hurt a little bit. You need to get burned a little bit just to prove to yourself who you really are, and to know that your intuition was right the entire time. So sometimes that's why we allow these things to happen. Sometimes we allow ourselves to be sucked a little bit by these energy vampires. Energy vampires are very real, and they are in abundance right now. They are running wild and free right now, because they are seeking energy to survive, and that's how they stay alive. They cannot survive on their own, so they need to take from the strong to become stronger, because it's a weak energy. All right, so there's a lot of people who are suffering right now. There's a lot of people who are in deep sadness and deep illness, and they are struggling in a mental warfare. And sometimes the only way they know how to stay alive is by sucking from someone else. And it comes in the most simplest ways. Sometimes the ways that it comes is, oh, you know, I want to support your business. I want to give you an offering, and overly praising you when they didn't even know you. They're beyond a fan of yours, just a new fan out of nowhere. Beyond, they know everything. They research, they watch everything you do, they study everything to you, and they want to be a part of you. I have experienced this more than once. I've experienced this in my actually for my whole lifetime, to really understand what this energy is and how this energy works. So I know this energy is very real. But what I will say is that during this time period that we're living in a very critical time period, a very intense time period. And in this time period, it is important to stay protected, keep your energies protected, you know? And like I said, there's gonna be very sneaky ways that these energies come. Then they come like as if they're your best friend, and they come like they're willing to support, and they come like they're on your team. But they're not, and you will know it. You know how you will know it? Pay attention to how you feel after you finish your communication, after there's any transaction that happens. How does it feel to you? Is it really worth it? Is any exchange or financial monetary exchange, how does that feel? Does that feel good to your spirit? You know, or are they giving you a runaround, or just giving you pieces of this and pieces of that, and making you overly work for something, or promises and they don't come through, or this confusion and the communication and the back and forth and the back and forth. I promise you, it is an energy vampire. It is someone who wants to string you along. They have no real intention of supporting you. Their only intention is to suck you dry and to take from you. How do I know this? Because I've experienced it over and over again. So I know it when I see it. And anytime I don't listen to that energy, I just laugh and I say, see, now you see. You know what you feel is true. And sometimes I allow that energy to happen just so that I can study it more. You know why? Because I want to come back and tell the lesson. I want to come back and teach the lesson, because I know it's real. So be protected. Be protective of how much access that others have. I'm talking to the light beings, the light workers, the spiritual beings. Be very mindful of how much access others have to your energy. Be very close and be rightfully guarded, okay? Guard that energy, rightfully guarded. I call it rightfully guarded. It's okay to be guarded. You know, sometimes people say you have your guards up too much, you need to let your guards down. This is not the time to let your guards down. This is the time to keep your guards up, to double guard yourself and keep protection around you, you know, and keep yourself spiritually protected, and to stay in wise counsel, and to communicate with your tribe, with your peers, okay, with other fellow workers in the same energy work field that you're in. Because if you're experiencing something, more than likely, others are experiencing the same thing, okay? So protect your energy, protect your space. Your space is sacred, what you have is sacred, your gifts are sacred, and this goes to anyone who understands energy and who works to stay on top of their energy, or who works to keep the energy high. This is the time to stay protected. Protect your energy field and your energy space, especially during this movement that seems like everyone is there rooting for you. Not everybody is rooting for you, even if they look like you, even if they have the same color skin as you, doesn't mean they're always rooting for you, okay? There's a lot of people who want to be like you, okay? So they want to get close to you. They want to get close to you. Why? Because they want to have a piece of you. They want to have a piece of your energy. They want to have some of your spirit. And you'll know if you feel aggravated, if you feel frustrated, if you feel annoyed, and it doesn't feel like a smooth flow, then it's not a flow and it gotta go. Protect your energy.